Byrds, we played the Fillmore Auditorium in San Francisco. We used to play there a lot. And that night, Michael Bloomfield and his band was on the bill, right? I'm still struggling with the new technology. Anyway, so the Bloomfield Band and the Byrds, and then we jammed together. It was really cool. So, you know, you gotta understand the record company mentality. They wanted to make a live Mike Bloomfield and Electric Flag album. So they used the Byrds as like a set, like a technical rehearsal for the technicians. So they recorded our show, but they didn't do anything with it. It stayed in the vaults for, years, you know? And then one day somebody said, hey, you know what? We can make money off this. So they released it, I don't know, 10 years ago. It's called Byrds Live at the Fillmore. But what we used to do in those days is, in order to allow more time for the tunes we wanted to play, we would sometimes squeeze some of the hits together. Not that we didn't like playing them, but we wanted more time to play other things, right? So this has haunted me ever since. So whenever I play with a band, I sort of have to do this. It's okay, I like doing it. This is the medley that we used to do. Kind of gives you a little bit of turn, and a short version like the record of Tambourine Man. Like, you know, there's four verses. With Gene Clark, we used to do two, sometimes three, usually I'd do four. And then we throw in 8 Miles High at the end, so I don't want to ruin the surprise for you, but I just did.
Take me for a trip upon ya.
Yeah.